I know I'm taller than you, but not that fucking much.
I was slouching in the space between us video, so Sarah looked like she was about five. Sarah is about 5 feet taller than me, though.
To be fair.
Yeah. Hey, anyway, the trend of let's bring back the early 2000s is continuing.
So, yeah, January part two started tonight.
Thank God. My feeling is like there was a mix-up on what to release when, and Rings got released in February while Split, a really good horror film, got released in January.
It throws everything off, because that was my big thought this morning, was like, well, maybe they held off until February because it might actually be good, but they didn't want it to get lost in the whole January horror movie dumping ground that it's become.
There's no chance of this movie being good. You know, isn't there like a Ring versus Grudge movie coming out?
I know it's been making like some festival stuff, like, coming from overseas.
You know what? That makes sense, because we just sat through the Ring versus Don't Breathe.
Yeah.
You know,
that was,
all right, you've seen Don't Breathe, right? Picture he got away with it and impregnated the girl, and then she gave birth to the girl from The Ring. I don't give a shit if I'm spoiling it, because you know that part in the trailer where the girl is pulling hair out of her throat? That's the end of the movie. It's one of those.
I honestly, because that scene, never came up until, the last minute of the film, I honestly was starting to think, it's just a take that, shoot one for the trailer.
I kind of forgot about it until the end, because I'm not going to lie, I checked out so hard in this movie. Through a majority of it, I was like, you guys are investigating something that I already know the answers to, and what I don't know the answers to, I've seen Don't Breathe, and it's a way better fucking movie than this.
Yeah, it's the problem with... I still don't really know, is this a reboot, or is it a sequel?
I honestly couldn't tell you, because, I enjoyed the Naomi Watts one, but it's been since it first came out that I saw it.
I watched it a couple years back,
mm-hmm.
and I don't remember there being anything wrong with it. It's a pretty straight adaptation for the most part. It's that's them, but speaking English.
I never saw the second one.
Yeah, I never got further in on the American side of them.
I've seen Fear.com. I actually kind of liked that movie, honestly. Fear.com was The Ring if it took place in the Seven universe and was a sleazy cop movie after a serial killer. I don't know. To me, that was kind of more of an update on The Ring than this movie is. And I think Fear.com came out before the American version of The Ring by, maybe a month or two.
Oh, yeah. I know it was around the same fucking time.
But... Yeah.
But yeah, I can honestly say, as bad as this is, it's not as bad as... I tried watching a couple years back a newer... sequel or tie-in or something from Japan to The Ring. It's just titled Sadako, after the Asian name that the little ring girl has.
Yeah.
And it involves kind of what was happening there at the end of the film. Like the video is a viral video online, and people it's a challenge thing, and people are watching it on fucking YouTube.
Yeah, and, everyone gets sent, hundreds of thousands and millions, maybe, people get sent this video at the end, and there, or maybe it's just all the people in his contacts, I don't know, but,
there was a lot of emails being sent, I don't know that many people that I have on email.
And they instantly, they write him back within seconds, and I'm like, you know what, if you think about it, most people would be safe, because... If I got an email...
I was about to say, if I got something from you that said, whoa, check out this spooky video,
yeah.
I'd be like, oh shit, Brad's email got hacked.
Yeah.
I put my phone down.
You're right. Yeah, I honestly think a majority of people would be safe. And the people who aren't, are probably the same people who maybe fall for, like, a Nigerian prince scam. Or yeah. Maybe, like, Tom Atkins kids from the end of, like, Halloween 3.
Just, like, not that they're gullible, just they haven't come across anything yet to where it's like, oh, this is a bad thing.
Yeah, yeah. So, there's one thing about this movie that could have been slightly interesting. Johnny Galecki is in this, and in the moments that we kind of see his character,
I want to know more about what the fuck he was doing.
Thank you, right? He's sort of like Bill Pullman in, like, The Grudge. It's sort of like, I kind of want to follow what was going on with this guy.
Yeah, because he, after this very bizarre cold open.
Uh-huh. Oh, fuck.
Where it's
on a fucking plane.
Where it's the fake out dream sequence from the beginning of Final Destination, except it really happened, I guess.
I've got this. They said I'm gonna die in 7 days. All this evil stuff keeps happening to me. It's probably gonna come true. I should maybe get on a plane.
Yeah, that makes the most sense.
Oh God, that was so fucking. It's just one of those openings that was just there to be a pre-credit, to be a big pre-credit.
So they could,
sequence.
Yeah, do like a big flashy thing of like, oh man, all the like seat back like TVs on the plane are switching over to the Ring video. Wow.
You see this in the trailer. Like, that's another reason why this scene is in there, just so they can put that shit in the trailer. It barely fucking has anything to do with anything else in the movie.
It's the movie that they were making at the beginning of Urban Legends.
I think it might be the same plane that, like, Vin Diesel was on at the beginning of Last Witch Hunter.
But yeah, like, after that, like, Johnny Galecki gets, like, fast forward to 2 years later, he manages to get a hold of the tape that the guy from the cold open had watched.
And he's selling a VCR in like, a yard sale or some shit. And they're treating it as if it's, like, a 100-year-old printing press.
Yeah, they're like, it's like,
what's
oh,
that?
Like, this was the height of technology back in its day. It's like, what do you mean back in its day? Like,
I can still go to Walgreens and get a thing of blank VHS tapes.
Like, I was still renting VHSs from places when I was in high school. I mean, granted, that was 15 years ago, but, I mean, it's not exactly like it was another fucking era.
Uh-huh. Yeah, exactly. I'm like, well, okay, I know this is made for this. I know that this is made for the same type of audience that shit their pants during the Bye Bye Man. So.
Truth.
Alright, so it's gonna have stupid shit like that in there, but Johnny Galecki is this, like, pot-smoking college professor, and when the movie started out, I kind of thought he was gonna be the main character at first, and then I was sort of interested, because as much as I really don't like the Big Bang Theory, I've always liked Johnny Galecki.
Yeah, I've got no issues with him.
Yeah, so Johnny Galecki is sort of running this underground system with all of these students in which they all have, like, time codes on the wall that says how much time they have left. Like, I don't really know how Johnny Galecki found all this shit out about the fucking tape, but, you know, maybe if he was the main character and it focused on him, we could have figured that shit out.
There's a much different movie where all of this gets explained.
Yeah. And so he's got all these students together to create these tales that
we're basically like they're staggering themselves. We're like, one person will watch the tape and then document like the weird shit that's happening to them, but then before they hit the 7-day marker, they basically like draft someone else into watching their copy of the video. Then it passes to them, and then they just keep like cycling like that to kind of get through it.
That's a way, and that, by the way, is only about 5 minutes of this movie. Like, honestly, us explaining
took about as long as the movie did.
Yeah. And right there is a much more interesting movie than what we get, because what we do get oh, it's young 20-something-year-old girl, her college boyfriend saw the tape, and then the two of them have to go and investigate it together. They're the two most fucking uninteresting leads that I've seen since the last shitty horror movie that we went to go see.
Well, and it was distracting for me the whole time, because, yeah, it's like watching them, it's like, oh, well, fake Jessica Alba and fake Zac Efron.
That guy looked like if an alien species tried creating their own Adam Scott.
He looked like if a little kid drew a picture of a person and you made that into a real boy.
Right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There's like not enough room on his face for all of his features, so I don't know, he had like a small face but normal sized features, so it just everything looked crowded.
Well, it made sense, because that's the guy from The Fifth Wave, and at least he played an alien in that. Like, all right, sure. In this, damn, that girl is awful. And he was just bland. So yeah, like, we're following around these young college thing. With
even
the,
she didn't look scared when she was supposed to be scared.
No. Oh, like, my God, what's that? Right, that's her tone throughout this whole fucking movie. And I'm sitting there like, yeah, real original, guys. Give us these two fucking lead characters. There's a much more interesting movie with Johnny Galecki right there, if you would just focus on that.
Although, all of the parts with like the college and like his experiment that he was running, and the fact that most of this movie is filmed like at night in the dark.
Even when it's daylight, I couldn't see what was fucking going on in this
movie.
Yeah,
there are several times when like she's like opens a door into a blank room and you hear noises, and I feel like we're supposed to be able to see what's in there, but we just can't.
Yeah. This movie isn't even in 3D. I don't think it was a problem with the projector being set too dark. It's just shot in 2003 horror movie vision.
Because the whole, like, that whole first part with the way that they were doing it and the whole parts with, like, the school and everything before those two basically just break off and have their own movie, really, really, really reminded me of the U.S. remake of Pulse.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, because all of those movies kind of look the same, honestly.
But that one had, like, a very, like, washed, very, like, saturated sort of color palette to it. And, yeah, that's where I felt like this one was. Like, it's always, like, dark and stormy outside, even when it's daytime.
And, yeah, it felt like just that era when we got about 5 American remakes of Japanese horror movies a year, and they all kind of looked the same. Like, even if you didn't know something was, if you didn't know right away something was maybe a remake of a Japanese horror movie, you could kind of figure it out really quickly.
Yeah. Like, honestly, this feels like the U.S. remake that we should have had back then for The Ring.
This? I mean,
just kind of on the trend of like how some of those you know, foreign remakes were, this feels more, because I remember, you know, like we were saying, like the Naomi Watts one, like it honestly isn't that bad.
But no,
this felt more like what we should have gotten
to go along with the other, like, sort of really bland ones that we got.
Yeah,
back
like
then.
Like how Pulse is a terrible one.
One missed call.
Yeah, the One Missed Call was awful.
The Eye,
which actually did have Jessica Alba.
Yeah,
Shudder was bad.
I didn't see Shudder. I wasn't a fan of The Grudge. I really didn't. The Ring is, you're right, The Ring is way more ambitious than a lot of those movies. Like than a lot of those other movies. Like, the other movies that came out afterwards seemed less like they were kind of aping off of the horror movies they were based on, and more they were just kind of aping off the success of The Ring.
Yeah.
So The
just
Ring,
riding that wave on in.
Yeah. So the Ring, what, you're right. This, if The Ring was a much more just kind of like just shit that on out into theaters remake, then yeah, this is what it would have looked like back then. And I wasn't that, the ring I liked just fine, but like, yeah, most of those I really wasn't a fan of back then, and this,
They haven't aged well. I watched a couple of them last October. They haven't aged well.
This I didn't like either, because I sat there not being scared by a goddamn thing in this fucking movie.
The biggest reaction out of the entire crowd, which crowd is a very
it wasn't that crowded in there.
But the biggest reaction out of everybody was when someone, like, they were leaving that church, and it cuts to shot of, like they're walking out of the church, and then it cuts to outside with just, floop, like, umbrella opening.
Yeah.
It was the biggest reaction this movie got, was people being afraid of an umbrella.
I was about to mention that, yeah. This movie has a jump scare with a fucking guy opening an umbrella. And it's like you just said, it's not like they're going through the closet and then the umbrella falls and they're looking for something. No, it's not that. It's not even like, oh, someone bumps into him with an umbrella. No, it is just cut to the next scene and the guy's opening the umbrella in front of the camera.
Hard cut. To umbrella.
Like, why? You fucking lazy ass jump scare movie? like the people sitting behind us, I could hear them jumping every now and then, but they weren't really being that obnoxious about it, you know?
It was just like, oh.
Yeah.
These guys are getting more out of it than we are. Like, good for them, I guess.
Right. You could kind of hear them laughing a little bit afterwards, which, is understandable because it's a dumb as shit movie. So if it's like when we laughed at Nick when he jumped at the phone ringing in The Fourth Kind.
What the fuck was that?
He did not just jump at this.
You were so mad at him.
I was. I just was so mad during that movie. Him. You son of a bitch. I saw what you did. I'm never talking to you again. Fuck that movie. Jesus. I can't say this movie really made me mad because I felt like I was asleep through half of it.
there was definitely a point towards the middle. Right about the time that she decided to, like, head back to the church in the middle of the night, where, like, I kept catching myself, like, my eyes getting heavy. I'm like,
dude, I was too.
It's like, I kept like if I just close my eyes, I'll be real comfortable. I'm like, no, but I'm not at home. We're here. Like, I have to see this for the site. It's like, wake back up.
Are you kidding? I was fighting falling asleep in this too. Like, seriously, because
it's just nothing happens, and it feels like you're just watching a movie that you've already seen because
it is.
You have.
Yeah. Like, I've already seen this movie. I know exactly what beats this is gonna go in, and then the ones it doesn't, I've seen in a much better movie last year. And the acting is, it's a dreary movie to look at, and the acting is too wooden to give a shit about. There's nothing to this movie.
Well, yeah, and that was the thing that, like, D'Onofrio brought his usual sort of, you know, D'Onofrio-ness to it. Like, he was still playing it like he's fucking Wilson Fisk.
Yeah, Vincent D'Onofrio was
intimidating and terrifying even when he's not supposed to be.
Vincent D'Onofrio was his character from Sinister if his character from Sinister created Bagul.
That's a very good way of putting it, yes. But yeah, his character was interesting right until the point that they made him Stephen Lang's character from Don't Breathe.
Yeah.
At which point I was like, I checked out completely on that. Yeah. 'Cause I'm like, it's like, I've already seen this done better.
Uh-huh. I have, and this movie really felt like it just kept going to the point to where near the end, one character goes, oh no, it's not over yet. And I'm like, really? It's not? Like, we're seriously past the 90-minute mark here.
Can't it please be over yet?
Right? It's like, I know you're going to throw something at me at the end where it's like, oh no, it's starting again. Hence the hair shit from the trailer. But, God, I don't care. Like, I just really wanted this movie to be over with so bad.
And there was a part, I don't know if you noticed it. It bugged the shit out of me.
Are you talking about the facial hair?
Yeah. Yeah. The terrible reshoot in the middle.
Uh-huh.
It felt really awkward.
Mm-hmm.
That, okay, so, like, in every scene that that Johnny Galecki has, he's got like not a beard, but like 5 day stubble. Like you give him another like long
7 day stubble.
Yeah, you give him like another like long weekend, and it's a fucking beard.
Yeah,
and it just looks really haggard and everything in all the shots he's in. They kind of start figuring out, like, it's like, no, like, she watched the tape and now it's different. And she, you know, the main girl decides, like, oh, we need to find this town where all this happened and go there. It's drawing me there. And he's like, okay, wait, hold on. Phone's ringing. Okay, yeah, it's the cops. They're coming because, like, one of our friends died, and they think I did it. And that I thought was a weird note to kind of leave on. And he's like, you guys, you need to go. I'll handle the cops. Then it cuts to outside, and all three of them are leaving the building. Like, I thought he was going to stay.
Yeah.
And then they stop, like, next to his car so he can, like, hand them, like, a folder full of his notes. Which it seemed like all of his stuff was upstairs. I don't know why all the important stuff was in his passenger seat of his car.
Which I guess meant that he was driving to meet the police? Because I was thinking about that too. I'm like, is he just driving to the police station? And before then, when he's on the phone, it's after the girl watches the newest Ring video. So it turns out to be it's the cops calling him, like you said, and I'm sitting there like, if it wasn't the cops calling and it was him that answered and it was the girl, was he gonna turn and just be like, it's for you? Like,
that's honestly what I was waiting for it to be. But once they get down to his car, he reaches in, like, they're kind of talking, like here, you're going to need all these papers. This is all my research I have on it. And he stands up, and you catch him in, like, the light of, like, the street lamp they're under. And just clean shaven, like, so did he stop on the way down here? Like, hey, guys, are you getting ready to leave? Okay, hold up. Give me, like, 5 minutes. I just have to get a quick full shave in here. Get all nice and cleaned up. But then the next shot we see him in is what we can only assume is the next morning based on, you know, how this is going. And it's right back to, like, full fucking stubble. It's like they didn't even attempt to match it up. It's like,
no.
It's like, hey, Johnny, can we get you in here for, like, I don't know, like, 5 minutes tonight? Like,
we need you here in, like, 2 hours.
Yeah, let me just finish working on the bang here real quick. I'll be right there. I'll be right down, like. It's like, shit, isn't he? Fuck. Roll with it. No one will notice. No one will give a shit.
I heard you next to me going, like, did he shave on the way down? What just happened?
It's like the whole time just, like, shaving as they're going upstairs.
This movie wanted him dead. Not only does he get into a huge car accident, but he's laying in a puddle off a bridge in which a telephone pole with a transformer attached to it falls on his car, as if that wouldn't kill him already. No, the electrical wire goes into the puddle that he's laying in.
Electrocutes him, and then it's just sitting there, like, sparking on top of the car. I was honestly waiting for it to do, like, and then the car explodes or something. Just,
yeah.
Really put a button on it.
If that had happened, I would have been, or even without that happening, with the car blowing up, it's like, whoever made this is a real fan of Final Destination. Between the opening scene and poor Johnny Galecki's death scene in this. And
yeah, death by Rube Goldberg device.
Yeah. Look, I don't recommend this at all, honestly. Like, no. I really don't. Like, man, like, even if you want to put on something on Netflix to kind of laugh at it, it's honestly a little too lame for that. And there's probably 100 other American J-horror knockoffs you could watch instead that would either be better or that you could probably get a better laugh out of than this.
Because, yeah, like, like, again, like Pulse, like, this really reminded me of Pulse. And that one, like, you can get a couple, like, you know, good smirks out of.
Uh-huh.
Like, when they, like, I think the that movie is set in, like, Cincinnati, but there's several scenes of them getting on and off the subway. I'm like, there's no subway in Cincinnati. Don't even fucking play. But, I mean, that's a small thing, but, like there's some dumb stuff, and it gets really dumb towards the end. So, you know, it's you know, laugh along with that one. Like, this is just, it's boring. Like, it's yeah, it's not even, like, a so bad that it comes back around type thing. Or it's not. Like, oh, it'll be, like, this will be, like, a thing that, like, you could put on in the background, like, if you have, like, some people over and just kind of, like.
Yeah.
It's just, it's boring.
It'll
it's dull.
It'll put people to sleep. It'll put people to sleep. It's just not scary. It's not even that I necessarily sat there feeling insulted or angry, even though its existence is a little insulting, but it's just too boring to work up any kind of extreme reaction towards.
Yeah, and that's about the worst way you can end up.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's you can't get excited because it's good. You can't get mad because it's really awful. It's just,
we still bring up how shitty The Apparition was, and that was 3 years ago.
We're not to gonna be fair, it was awfully shitty.
No, exactly. It's a fucking terrible, like, shockingly inept movie. We're not going to be bringing this fucking movie up again in
it'll be one of those
in future reviews, unless it's on one of our worst lists at the end of the year.
Yeah, it'll be the one when, come, you know, January next year, it's like, oh yeah, Rings.
Yeah, Rings. That was a thing that happened.
And I'm sure that by then there's going to be 10 other things that are worse. It'll be the one that's like, it's like, oh yeah, I'm like, couldn't even muster up an opinion on that one.
Yeah. So number 7. I'm sure I'll see 10 movies that are far worse than this, at least more memorably so.
Right.
this is just not good. It's pointless. There is no reason for this movie to exist. There's none whatsoever.
This was released because they made it, and they're like, fuck me, how are we going to get all that money back?
Throw this out in theaters. Throw it out in February.
Yeah, let's kick it out there right before, like, you know, like, we need to get into the good stuff, but it's right before, like, you know, like, the next couple weekends are going to be taken up by, like, you know, Super Bowl, Oscars coming up before long. Like,
oh, next week is 50 Shades Darker, Lego Batman, and John Wick Chapter 2.
Any one of those, I will assume, will have a much better first day than this movie is going to do in its lifespan.
Probably. Unless it really gets in that bye-bye, man, audience we had a few weeks ago. Yeah, we're not at the Friday screening for this. We're at the preview.
It's true. It might be packed tomorrow. Yeah, no, if you're going to go to the fucking theater this weekend to watch a horror movie, go watch Split. It's still out. It's doing really good.
Yeah. Split was awesome.
Go watch that.
Just fucking go see Split. Oh, see fucking Rings. Jesus Christ.
I guess there's no accounting for taste with some people.
I say that, but there's plenty of shitty things I like. Split's fucking great, though. Go check that out. Oh, yeah. Rings, just... Why see? You're gonna forget about it. Fuck that. Fuck this fucking movie.
Or hell, if you really want to go see something at the theater, wait until next week. Fucking John Wick's coming out.
John Wick Chapter 2's coming out next week. Yeah. Even if we leave that going, that was disappointing, it'll be better than what we just fucking sat through with this fucking movie.
The trailer for John Wick has a higher body count than the horror movie we just saw.
Mm-hmm.
There's something to put into perspective.
That's very true.
What was the body count in this movie? Two people? Three?
I guess the plane at the beginning, but it's not like we saw it. They just say in the next scene, oh, the plane crash happened.
There was
the girl so she could reenact
Johnny Galecki's
girl. Johnny Galecki, the girl who had to reenact the ghost face death from in the closet from the first one.
And then D'Onofrio.
Yeah. Yeah, and Vincent That's D'Onofrio. It.
Three people.
Spooky.
Anyway. Over the whole 2 hours.
Yeah, yeah. This is like an hour and 50 minutes. It has fucking no business being that is long.
Way, way too long.
Well, I don't have anything else. Any other final thoughts about this?
I got fucking nothing, man. I didn't have really much when we started, and I got nothing.
We got nothing, man.
Don't watch this movie. Like, it's not worth your time.
The movie had nothing, and we got nothing. See it.